Hello! In this tutorial, I'll guide you through creating a menu background replacement mod for Project Zomboid. If you're looking for specific steps, you can skip around using chapters. You can find the mod template in the description below for download. After you download it, go to your C drive, find your user folder and username. Then scroll down and find Zomboid. Go to Workshop. This should be empty if you haven't made any mods besides this one. Copy the template folder here and rename it to name you want. It has to be unique name or it will conflict with other mods. This won't be the name of the mod in the workshop, just in the game files. In this video, I'll be using my lo-fi girl image as a background for the menu. So I'm naming it lo-fi underscore menu underscore BG. You can choose any name, but remember it for later. Open the folder and here we need a preview image. This will be your workshop thumbnail. Create a PNG file with the size of 256 by 256 and name it preview.png. I've already prepared a preview image, so I'm just gonna paste it here. It has to be PNG file with this resolution. Next, inside the contents mods, you have to rename the mod folder with the same name as before. Go inside. And here we have poster image. Now these can be any resolution, but they have to be PNG files. These will be preview images that will be shown in game. Now open mod info with a text editor. For this tutorial, I'll be using Notepad++. First line under name is what will be displayed in the game. In my case, lo-fi main menu background. The second line points to the posters. You can have multiple here, but one is fine. Just name them the same as you named your images. I prepared two, so I will have two of them. The third line, ID, is what the game is going to look for when loading our mod, so change this to match your mod's name. The last line is just a small description of your mod that will only be visible in the game. In the media folder, if you're only replacing the menu background, you can delete the Lua and sound folders. Those are used for replacing menu music and main Zomboid logo. But first, let's make the menu background images. Open the UI folder. As you can see, the menu background is divided into four images. To create those, we are going to use the template I provided. Open it either in Photoshop or in GIMP or any other software that can open PSD files. For this tutorial, I use GIMP. There are layers for all the images we need. Now import your custom image. I'll use my lo-fi image. Now we have to cut it in four pieces. Right-click the first layer, select alpha to selection. Now right-click the image, then image, and select crop to selection. This will create one of our images. And then up here, file, export as. Then I go to our mod folder, copy to path, paste it here and then override the image. In this case, title. You can just save those images where you want to and then replace them in the mod folder. And now we have to do this with all four images. So Ctrl Z to go back on our edit. Then again, go to layers, select the next layer, right click, then select alpha. Right click on the image, then image and select crop to selection. Go up here again, file, export as, and now replace the title tree image. Remember which layers are you selecting and then replace the corresponding image. Now do this with all the rest of the images. The last image is just your full image, but with this name. So let's replace this as well. This is all you need for a basic background replacement. But there is one more thing we can do. These four dark images are used for when the lightning strikes in the menu to switch to a different image. If you don't have a second image to use, you can just keep them as they are. They will just make the menu flash slightly darker. But if you do, just repeat the steps we did and replace them with your second image. Remember to keep the names the same. Now to replacing the logos. You can change all the logos that show up before the game starts by just replacing these four files. But these three you have to keep the resolution the same. For this one, you can also use full screen 1080p image. If you don't want to change them, you can delete them. If you want to replace the main Zomboid logo in the menu, you have to replace this file. Keep the resolution the same, otherwise, position in the menu might not be correct. You can rename it to what you want, but if you do, you also have to change the name in the HD logo Lua file, located in the Lua folder. But you don't have to change the name for this to work. To replace menu music, let's go back and in the sound folder, there is new song underscore one file. Replace it with your music, but it has to be in .ogg file format. It can be any length. You can also rename it, but then you have to also change the name in the new song Lua file, located in the Lua folder. But you don't have to change the name for this to work. Now let's check out the mod in the game. Go to mods, find your mod and activate it. For this to work properly, you have to restart the game. Looks like everything is working. We have our new background, logo and music. If you want to upload this to Workshop, just click on Workshop, select your mod, set the name. Description can be changed later on your Steam page. You can add tags, but don't forget to set visibility to hidden or unlisted, so the mod is not released immediately. So you can add images and description on your Steam Workshop page. Click Next, then choose This is new item and upload. Then on your Steam page, you can change all the info. After you're done, put visibility to be public. And that's pretty much everything. I hope this was helpful and see you next time.